Okay, earlier I showed you how to lay out a rectangle base. I have added three rows of triple twining to my base, and now I'm going to show you how to do French randing. So I've chosen to use some space dyed reed, and I like that because you kind of get a surprise of how it comes out with color. So the first thing, I've decided that I'm going to go 7 spokes. So I'm under 1, over 1, under 1, so now we're at 3, over 1, 4, under 1, 5, over 1, 6, under 1, 7. Now they're going to be at this kind of angle right here. And I do not wet this reed, I weave it dry. Now at this place, I'm going to cut my weaver behind that spoke, and then I'm going to take my reed and move to the spoke in front of where I placed my first weaver. And again, I'm under 1, over 1, under 1. I'm going to do 7, and I should end, if I've done 7, behind the spoke, just in front of the last weaver. Okay, so, and then again, I just cut it behind my spoke. I can go back in later and trim my ends. Okay, a little trickier coming around a corner, but that's okay. We still put it behind a spoke, over a spoke, and again 7 spokes, and then we end our weaver. Okay, so let's come back down here to our end, and I've got a little end there, but I'll trim that later. Put it in there, go over 1, behind 1. Now I'm shaping my corners and my space between, and then again 7 spokes, which ends 1 spoke in front of my last weaver. Okay, so we'll come here, and now it's going to go behind the next spoke and go over under. And each time I come around, it makes my corner a little better and holds it in place a little better. So again, 7. And so we'll end that there. Come back around. Again, behind. Over. And there's my corner starting to take shape really nicely for me. Okay, and we can move our spokes around to kind of keep the spacing equal. So we've gone around and put our French randing around our basket, and now we've come back to the beginning. And it's a little trickier here because we're going to have to work our way through these right here, but we're going to take this one, we're going to put it right in front of the last one we put in, we're going to go over under. Remember, our repeat is 7 spokes. And it always ends 1 spoke in front of the last weaver. So we'll cut that, pack them down a little bit. Same thing here. This one needs to go under here. So it's gonna go under there, over and under, okay? And then we just weave it across 7 spokes, and then we're going to cut it 1 spoke before our last weaver was cut. So we'll cut it right there. Okay. Again, back to here. We're over this one, under this one. Now we have to go under this one, over this one, under this one. Now this has put us, this is the last spoke we put one in, now we're putting one in here. So it's been under, over, under, over, that's four. And now we're back to where we put our last spoke, last weaver in. We'll cut the spoke just before that. And back to this. Now we still have three spokes, or two spokes here, that don't have a beginning weaver. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna open this space up a little bit, and we're gonna kinda, we know it has to go over here, under here, over here, so let's start it like this. And then just kinda thread it through to where we need to get it. And then it's gonna go behind that spoke. And so, and again, it's seven spokes, and we're again back to the spoke to the left of the last spoke that we cut. So now we only have one more to get in there. And there's different ways, whatever you find easiest, but I kind of just thread it through. And by the way, I have dampened these weavers here to make them more flexible. So now we have one behind each spoke, and we've got to make sure that we weave this seven spokes. And a miracle, this is our last weaver, the spoke we cut it behind, we'll cut this one. And then this was the very first weaver we put in, and it worked out to be in the correct place. Okay, so we'll pack all this down. Okay, now we're gonna do a reverse French randing. And I'm a right-handed person, and I just wove mine right-handed. Now the direction I'm going to do is left. Yeah, it might be a little bit slower, but that's okay. So again, we're gonna go behind a spoke where we cut an end. And so we're under one, over one, under one, over one, under one, over one, and we slipped out of there, so we're coming back. And then we're still working with seven spokes, okay? Now again, when we come back, we're gonna have to work to get these in here, just like we did before. So we cut this there. We go one spoke in front of the last weaver, and we go seven spokes. And of course, it ends in the correct place, the seventh spoke. And we cut behind the seventh spoke. And we just keep doing this until we come back to the beginning. But we're creating a little arrow here, if you can see it. These little arrows. Okay, this one's going to end behind this spoke. Okay, so we now have done our French randing in the other direction, and we have come around. You can see our little arrow forming, and so now we're back again where we have to figure out how to get this part in here. So it takes a few patience, I'm going to continue with this one over here. Okay. And it's going to go behind this one. And it gets cut. Okay. Now, it's going to go under this one, over this one, under, over. This is our handle spoke. And again, and this place will cut this one. Okay, so it gets a little more difficult, but if you'll slide those up and give yourself some working space, it helps. This one's under. It's under here, over there, under, so sometimes it's easier just to come at it in this direction and put that in there, and then come over here and weave your seven spokes. And cut it in. Okay. And so we now have this one, but we need to get one here. So we're going to go over, under, over. So we could just thread it through like this. Might be easier. And that's pretty easy. And then we just come over here and move it. And again, it's going to go under this spoke, but over, under, over. So we could just thread it in like this, over, under, over. And then this is where it goes, right there. And maybe just hold that down so that you can kind of. And then come back here and finish it so that you have your this one. And we still have one more, and it's probably the most difficult, but we know it's going to go under this one, so it's going to go over this one, under. So let's do this. Under. We're over, under, over, under, and then push it in here. Straighten things out a little bit. Take our little packer, lift us up some space, slide it in there. Didn't go far enough. So this one comes up over, then it goes under this one. Knew I was working too hard. If you're working too hard, sometimes it is a problem. Okay, so go back here, cut it behind our spoke. Okay, now all we have left to do is do some packing, and that's our French randing with a reverse French randing. So, I'll see you in a little while, and I'll show you how to braid the handle on this basket.
Oh boy, howdy.